ever wondered what happened to the little girl who used to open the Castro convertible in the TV commercials of the 1950s? She's Bernadette Castro, the daughter of the man who started the company. The rest is, of course, television history. At 4 years old, Bernadette became the star of what her father says is the first commercial for a local television. It was 1948.
We gotta get up early. Find out about that uranium mine. Oh. Pull out this bed and get some rest. Oh, this is murder. How do I... I remember I got a set of instructions with it. I also bought the accessories. Thank you.
I think, star of all stars, this particular performer has done more shows on television than any other performer. And she has also done a performance exactly as it should be. Hasn't changed and varied. She's always done the same show, the same good performance. And for me, she is really the star of all television. We have her here tonight, and here she is. Would you kindly open it up?
Like father, like daughter scenario, and some nostalgia as American as apple pie. Castro bought the first local TV commercials ever in New York City for $25 a minute. His daughter would appear 35,000 times. Castro convertibles would sell like crazy. Bernadette would become famous in her own right.
Dr. George's brother, Bernadette. Get Jennison with the NBC orchestra and me. I'm Ed McLean. And now, here's Johnny.
Young gal who's earned the title of the most televised girl in America. And welcome.
Thank you so much.
You know what I did today? I looked at furniture, at couches that turn into beds, and chairs that turn into beds, and lamps that turn into beds. And then, you know, I went to look at wedding rings.
This is a Castro convertible.
Ooh.
It pulls out.
Yeah.
There's a bathroom.
Right there.
You don't have a tub?
No, I don't.
What about upstairs?
Nope.
Yeah.
Okay. So, what did you two escape, or what?
Actually, we're going to Florida.
Well, all you have is mustard and your chickens.
So, what are you girls going to do in Florida?
I'm Jim Cramer, and welcome to my world.
It's better than investing in Zimbabwe, maybe, but not the First National Bank of Sealy. Now, I have a new Stearns & Foster mattress that set me back about $2,000. And if I had bought the Duxiana for 4Gs, I would have done better than if I followed Madoff's strategy. His clients should be banking at 1-800-MATTRESS and leave the S off for savings. In fact, they would have done better banking with Castro, of the convertible nature, of course. And I promise Mad Money, you can't afford to miss it.
It's Saturday Night Live.
Teresa Castro, one of the co-founders of the Castro Convertible Sofa Bed Company, died this week at the age of 85. Castro would have died in her sleep had not the hard metal bar from her fold-out bed been digging into her back.
Who's the genius that thought that up? The day bed, the whatever that is.
The sofa bed.
A couch that becomes a bed. I think it was Castro.
Maybe.
Bernadette Castro dreamt that up.
Well, I think her dad. She just runs the business.
Castro convertible.
Yeah.
Very, very cool. Like, I know, we can turn a couch into a bed. We're geniuses. And who would think Letterman would embrace that concept? It's a very old concept. Oh, he is an older man.
It seems old-fashioned.
Yeah. Seems kind of that when you're David Letterman, you're making $30 million a year, you get a bed in there.
Yeah.